Right, what you got? You're supposed to ask questions.
Name?
All right, Todd Sanford, Assistant Chief of the San Angelo Fire Department Operations.
Okay, when did this fire start?
You know, I don't know exactly. Sometime around 12 o'clock, I believe I got the call. It instantly went to second alarm. Right now, I believe we have probably 7 engines on scene. Out of those 7, we have 2 ladder companies, our rescue company. Both the fire chief, myself, are here. And it was a row of warehouses all put together. The first end companies did an amazing job. We were able to, I believe there's 4 different warehouses all attached, and the first end company was able to keep it to the original point of origin, the original building, and just did an amazing job. We saved thousands and thousands of square feet worth of building. These guys did a great job.
Okay. And the building itself, like, what's the situation with it right now?
The building that originally caught on fire was a total loss when we arrived. We had fire all the way from the ceiling all the way down. Right after the guys arrived, it vented through the roof. So it was totally involved very quick. That's why I say it was an amazing job by the San Angelo firefighters to stop it where it was, because anytime you have, we've had numerous fires in this warehouse district before, and usually you lose at least 2 of them, but they just did an outstanding job of realizing that one was gone and saving all the rest of the properties on scene.
Can you tell me what was the building that was lost?
I really don't know. I believe it was storage, had a bunch of different storage things in it. But I really don't know.
Okay. Any injuries?
I do have 1 captain that has heat exhaustion. Not serious enough to go to the hospital, but we have taken him off the line, and we've taken him back to the fire station to cool down. Extremely hot out here. It's not 108 degrees today like it normally is, but when you completely bunked out fighting a fire this hot, this many BTUs coming off a building, it's very damaging to the body. That captain was the first in captain on the scene here, and so we're gonna get him back, hire somebody overtime for him, and just cool him off, make sure he's okay.
All right.
We're definitely, now the fire's 100% contained. We're in the overhaul phase now, so we're gonna pull everybody out. We've stopped spraying water right now. We're gonna rehab everybody, cool them down. We're gonna start rotating some fresh crews from the other side of town in here and get these guys back, try to get them cooled down, get them some water in them, and rehydrate them, take care of them.
And once the place cools down itself, as far as, it'll be a couple hours from now, fire marshals will go in and investigate?
Fire marshals gonna go in. These buildings here have basements, and so we're not gonna put anybody in there. It's too dangerous to put anybody in there, so we'll do everything from the outside. We have an excavator coming.
Mm-hmm.
We will pull the walls out, and then we will go in there and check everything the best we could. We'll overhaul, make sure all the fire's out, but there's absolutely no reason to put anybody in these buildings from the basement there. Have them accidentally fall through and get hurt. It's not worth it.
So we're not able to find out the cause of the fire.
Fire marshals are on scene investigating, but I wouldn't plan on any information on that today.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Thank you so much.
You bet. Thank